To make any matches waterproof, cover them with a thin layer of transparent nail polish and let them dry well. To always have something to light them with, glue a piece of fine sandpaper to a lid of a plastic box and put matches inside. Cotton clothing won't keep you safe and warm out in the wild. It takes forever to dry from sweat or rain, and wet clothes lose heat 25 times faster than dry ones. If you don't want to freeze, go for polyester, nylon, or wool. Take microfiber towels that dry in an hour. If you're lost in a forested area, try to find a spot with dark or damp soil. It's likely there's water under it, and you can make a seep well for fresh drinking water there. Dig a hole about twice as wide as your arm from elbow to fingertip and half as deep. Use small rocks to line the side and the bottom to keep the dirt from your fresh water source. You can use your t-shirt or a bandana as a water filter. Put one end of it in a container filled with dirty water standing above an empty container for clean water. The other end goes in there, and the water pours in, cleansing itself on the way. Be sure to boil the filtered water before you drink it. Another use for your t-shirt is a dew collector. Wipe it over some grass covered with dew early in the morning, then squeeze it into a container and you'll have safe drinking water. You can also leave it in a rainstorm to collect some water. A clean shirt or fabric works best. To survive a waterfall plunge, take a deep breath as you are getting close to the edge. Reposition your body to go down feet first. Wrap your arms around your head and seal your nose from water with your elbows. Tense your muscles, put your legs together, and close your mouth and eyes as tight as you can. When you get to the bottom, start swimming away from the waterfall while you're still underwater. Now, if you ever fall into rapids, hold onto a boulder, a log, or whatever comes handy so that the water doesn't carry you deeper. Throw off any heavy gear and start swimming downstream in the direction of the shore. Don't stand up and walk even if the water seems shallow, because the currents can carry you back. To come out of a storm dry and warm, you can make yourself a waterproof trash bag mini shelter. Just make a hole for your face and put it on. Use two bags to keep your feet dry, too. You can also build an A-frame shelter out of a trash bag. Find some cordage for the central rib. Split the bag into a blanket and cover the rib with it. Use four rocks to keep the corners down. If you hear thunder outside, count the seconds between it and the lightning flash. If it's less than 30 seconds, you've got to hide somewhere, because the storm is too close. If you can't do that, at least stay away from tall, lone trees. If you're in a group, spread out to minimize the risks of everyone getting struck. To help your campfire keep you warm for longer, put some rocks around it. They'll keep the heat and spread it even when the fire is gone. You can also boil water with them if you drop a hot rock in a metal container with water. To escape quicksand, shift your weight to your right leg and shake your left foot to get it up to the surface. Get your left knee on top of the sand and shake your right foot to get it out into a kneeling position as well. When you're on solid ground again, carefully roll as far away from the quicksand as you can. If you find yourself trapped inside a cave, you have to stay calm and not use matches to light up your way. It can take some priceless oxygen from you. Protect yourself from breathing in dust with a t-shirt or whatever you're wearing. Just wrap it around your head. Make a whistle out of an acorn cap to call for help. Hold the cap with both hands between your thumb and index finger. Make a V with your thumbs near the top of the acorn. Hold it close to your mouth and let some air in that triangle in the cap. You gotta practice a bit to make a loud sound. To stay warm in the wild, use grass or leaves. Get them under your clothes or blankets for an extra layer of insulation. This tip works both for winter and summertime. You always risk losing more body heat than you can produce. To set a tree on fire even when it isn't dry, use the Swedish fire log technique. Set the log vertically, make a star-shaped incision as deep as possible. Put some splinters and dry grass inside the log and set it on fire. It should start burning quickly and last from 2 to 5 hours. No matter what size or type of wood you use. As you prepare to spend a night in the wild, find a big rock that can fit your sock or pillowcase. Put it close to your campfire to absorb some heat, but don't let it get burning hot. Turn it around so that it warms up on each side. Once it's ready, carefully wrap it in your cloth with two layers for better insulation and put it into your sleeping bag. In case you go kayaking and your vessel flips upside down, don't try to turn it over from underwater. Instead, get yourself out of it and swim deeper down and away from the kayak, and only then get out of the water. If you're nearsighted and lose your glasses or contacts in the wild, curl your index finger into a tiny hole and look through it. A pinhole works like a natural lens that lets the light through in one place and keeps things in focus. In case you're lost in the wild and want to escape as soon as possible, stop your attempts for the night. Hungry, nocturnal animals will just love to meet you out there. Plus, there can be insects and snakes on the ground that you'll never spot in the dark. If you don't have a sleeping bag, you better sleep above the ground. Don't climb on trees, you might easily fall from it at night. Instead, take any large piece of fabric, make knots on both ends, then tie a rope on each side and secure it between two trees. If you don't have a rope on you, why not? Nah, you can make one yourself out of plants. Just find some long grass, better dry one, and weave it together in a braid or just a cord. After a rendezvous with bugs and mosquitoes, put some toothpaste on the affected areas on your skin. Menthol will cool down those spots and reduce all the unpleasant sensations. A banana peel, some ice, or aloe vera will also work. To relieve a bad headache without a pill, chew on willow bark. It works just like aspirin. It shouldn't have any side effects unless you're allergic to aspirin or take too much of it. If you get lost, remember the rule of three to stay calm and do the right things in the right order. You can survive 3 minutes without air, 3 hours in extreme temperature, 3 days without water, and 3 weeks without food. So, start with building shelter, then get water, and only then take care of food. You can clear your car windows of mist with a raw potato. Rub a half of it on the inside of your windshield to spread the starch evenly across the glass. When it dries up, it'll stay on the glass, and it won't get misty again. You can see clearly now. The rain, the fog is gone.